For this blessed day of Friday, dear brothers and sisters in Islam, is all being good and dutiful to one's parents. Alhamdulillah, in our history, one of the greatest leaders is known as Harun al-Rashid. This was the greatest leader from the times of our Abbasids. He had a group of very close ministers called the Barbakiyun, a noble family. Then one day a fitna occurred between Harun al-Rashid, the Khalifa, and this family of Barbakiyun, the wealthiest, the most noble family at the time. So he threw all of them into prison. Alhamdulillah, amongst the people who were thrown into prison is a young boy called Al-Fadl ibn Yahya ibn Khalid al-Barbaki, rahimahullah. This man, alhamdulillah, he is in prison with his father. Al-Fadl ibn Yahya, with his father, they are in prison. Then he says to himself, Fajr time is going to come, and the water that my father is going to use for wudu is very cold. So alhamdulillah, he takes like a pot or a sufriya, and the entire night he spends carrying the water next to the lantern or to the lamp so that the water can heat with the lamp that is in the prison cell so that the father gets warm wudu in the morning. Then the prison guards, they notice this behavior and they say, no, for you to be severely punished, we're even going to remove the lights in the prison. So alhamdulillah, what does this young boy, this beautiful son, what does he do? He takes the sufuria or the pot and he keeps it on his stomach, lying with it the whole night so that the body heats the water so that the father can get wudu in the morning. كَذَٰلِكَ الْبِرُّ. This is how the righteous Muslims walk towards their parents. One day the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he sees himself in Jannah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he sees himself in Jannah. Then he hears someone reciting the Quran in Jannah. And he says, I know this voice. I know this voice. قَالُوا هَذَا الْحَارِثَ ابْنُ عُمَانِ. They say this is a Haritha ibn Uman. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, كَذَٰلِكَ الْبِرُّ. كَذَٰلِكَ الْبِرُّ. That is what birr, beautiful, being good to your parents makes you. وَكَانَ أَبَرَّ النَّاسِ بِأُمِّهِ. This Haritha ibn Uman radiallahu anhu was known by this attribute more than any other attribute. He was very good to his mother and he became amongst the people of Jannah. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this is our khutbah for this blessed day of Friday. What does the Quran of Allah say about being good to one's parents? What does the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam say about being good to one's parents? I want to ask some examples from our Islamic history with regards to being good to one's parents. Alhamdulillah, know that the right, the ultimate right for us as Muslims is the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the ultimate right. And the right that comes after it is the right of our parents. If it was not for Allah, you'd not be here. If it is not for your parents, you'd not be here. That is why you find the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in many verses, when He commands us to worship Him alone, free of partners, the second right that He mentions is the right of the parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that you ought not to worship except He, and to the parents, good treatment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. Worship Allah, do not associate any partners with Him, and be good to the parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, قل تعالوا أتل ما حرم ربكم عليكم ألا تشركوا به شيئا وبالوالدين إحسانا. Come O Muslims, I recite unto you what Allah has forbidden. Number one, do not associate any partners with Allah Azza wa Jalla. Worship only Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. All your ibadah has to be to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And number two, وبالوالدين إحسانا. And for the parents, you give good treatment. Yaqanifillah. If you want to be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, you have to be grateful to your parents. If you want to be grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal, you have to be grateful to your parents, even if your parents are not Muslims. If you are not grateful to Allah, you are not grateful to your parents. If you are not grateful to your parents, you are not grateful to Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ وَأَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ إليك المصير، إليك المصير، ووالديك إليك المصير. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, be grateful to me and to your parents. To me is the final destination. Ibn Abbas, the greatest Mufassir, one of the greatest scholars who translated the Quran, he says, Man shakar Allah, wa lam yashkur li walidayhi, lam yuqbal minhu. Whoever is grateful to Allah and they're not grateful to their parents, will not be accepted from them. Ikhwani fillah, this is the Quran of Allah Azza wa Jal, clearly showing to us that the right of the parent is a great right that comes even after the right of Allah Azza wa Jal. As for the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have one of his companions, it's called Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu. This man is unique. He asks very relevant questions, the hardest. One day he asks the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, what are the worst of sins? What are the worst of sins? And a separate place he asks him, what are the best of deeds of Prophet? So he asks, Ya Rasulullah, ayyul amal afdal, what is the best of deeds? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says to him, as-salatu bi waqtiha, performing the prayer upon its time. You know, it is the time of dhuhr. You pray dhuhr at the time of dhuhr, not dhuhr at the time of asr, or dhuhr at the time of maghrib. You are as-salatu bi waqtiha. Qultu thumma ay, what comes number two? Qala birrul walidain, being good, being dutiful to your parents. Qultu thumma ay, what is number three? Qala al-jihad fi sabilillah, muttafaqun alayh. Notice in this hadith of Allah, number one was salat. Number two was being good to your parents. And number three is the jihad fi sabilillah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam kept birrul walidain even before the jihad fi sabilillah. In a different hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn As radiallahu anhu, he says the Prophet, a man came to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, yasta'dhinu fil jihad, asking for permission to go fight for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam asks him one question. He says to him, ahayyul walidat, are your parents alive? He says, na'am, qala fa fihima fa jahid. Your jihad is taking care, being good to your parents, that is your jihad. You don't need to go for this one, you have other bigger responsibility. Ibadillah, this is the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam clearly showing to us the status of being good to the parents. Know, O Muslim, that the parents are not equal. The mother is greater than the father. If there was Olympics, Ibadillah, the mother will take the gold, the mother will take the silver, the mother will take the bronze, and the father comes number four. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam one day was asked the hadith of Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Man ahaqqu an-nasi bi husni sahabati, who is most worthy for me to be good to them? Qala ummuk, he says your mother. Qultu thumma man, then comes number two. Thumma ummuk, qala thumma man. Thumma ummuk, qala thumma man. Thumma aruq muttafaq alayh. Number one, he says, who am I supposed to be good to, a prophet? He says, number one, your mother. Okay, my mother, great. Number two, your mother. Number three, your mother. Number four, your father. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, different hadith, narrated by Baghdad ibn Ma'di Karib radiallahu anhu, he says, Inna Allah yusikum bi ummahatikum, thumma yusikum bi abaikum, thumma yusikum bil aqrab al aqrab. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, this authentic hadith, he says that he advises you, all Muslims, number one, to regard your mother. Number two, your fathers. Number three, the rest of your relatives. This hadith has been narrated by Imam Ahmad ibn Majah and Imam Bukhari in Adab al-Mufrad, wa huwa hadith sahih. Qani billah, this is the mother. Why does she have all this respect even more than the father? This lady, this poor lady miskina, she carried you in her womb for 9 months. 9 months, morning sickness, the heaviness, the bleeding, the sickness, the lack of sleep, she can't turn on the bed. 9 months she was carrying it. Then she gave birth to you in difficulty. It wasn't easy. The pain is like the pain of death. If us as men were supposed to give birth, we will survive that. She gives birth to you. Then the hard work begins, taking care of you. When you are asleep, that is the time she sleeps. When you're awake, she can't sleep. She has to take care of you. For 2 years, she has to breastfeed you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها. We advise the people to be good to their mother, to their parents. The mother carried her, carried you in difficulty upon difficulty. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه حملته أمه وهنا على وهن وفصاله في عامين أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير. We advise the people to be good to the parents. The mother carried you in a state of witness upon witness and your winning period was 2 years. Be grateful to me and to your parents. For me, it's the final destination. The final prayer. This is the right, the respect that we as Muslims have elevated our women. None is greater than the mother. None is greater than the mother, alhamdulillah. Look at the status that Islam has given her. Alhamdulillah, what you have mentioned are all authentic. But there's a hadith that is famous amongst the Muslims. Very popular hadith amongst the Muslims. The hadith that says, Al-Jannatu tahta aqdami ummahat. That Jannah is beneath the feet of mothers. Alhamdulillah, this hadith, Ibn Ali Al-Uqayli rahimahullah, they say, Du'afa, this is a fabricated narration. It is a lie. It is a weak narration. This hadith has been narrated by the foreign chain of narration. He says, Haddathana, the Prophet Muhammad, Musa ibn Muhammad ibn Afa. He says, Haddathana Abu Malih. Qala Haddathana Maymun an Ibn Abbas bihi marfu'a. This is the chain of narration of that hadith. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah, he says, Musa ibn Afa kadhab. Musa ibn Afa is a liar. Alhamdulillah, this is the status that the mother has been given in our religion. Alhamdulillah, Ibn Abbas radhiyallahu anhu, he says, Inni la a'lamu 'amalan aqrab ila Allah min birr walidayh. He says, I don't know any deed of Muslims that keeps you closer to Allah Azza wa Jal than being good to your mother. Imam Ahmed rahimahullah, he says, Birr walidayn kafaratul kaba'ir. You have done major sins. Be good to your mother, your father. If they're not alive, your auntie, your uncle, for they raised that position. Be good to them and you shall be forgiven whichever sins that you have, even the major sins. Yafani fillah, inna al-anbiya wa salihin kanu barreen biwalidihim. The prophets and the righteous people, they were very good, they were very dutiful to the parents. Look at the prophet Yahya alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يا يحيى خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبيا وحلالا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقيا وبرا بوالدي ولم يجعلني جبارا عسيا. He says, O Yahya, take the scripture with strength. We made you affectionate, we made you pure, we made you pious. And you are not a disobedient tyrant towards your parents. This is Yahya alayhi salam. You have the cousin of Yahya alayhi salam, one of the greatest prophets, Isa ibn Maryam alayhi salam, says, قال إني عبد الله آتاني الكتاب وجعلني نبيا وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت وأوصاني بالصلاة والزكاة ما دمت حيا وبرا بوالدتي ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا. Isa said, he was good to his mother and he was not a wretched tyrant. Yahya alayhi salam. This is Isa alayhi salam. You have one of the greatest prophets, the friend of Allah Azza wa Jal, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. One day he sees in a dream. He has only one child. He's reached the age of 90. He has only one child after a lot of du'as and a lot of prayers. Allah has given him one child at that time. Ismail alayhi salam. Then he sees in a dream that he's supposed to slaughter his own child. قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى. Oh my son, I've seen in the dream that I'm supposed to slaughter you for the sake of Allah. What is your opinion? Listen to what this beautiful child, this blessed child says. يا أبت افعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Oh my father, do what Allah has commanded you. You shall find me amongst the patient. أفعل الله the Muslims. Amongst them, the prophets, they make dua for their parents. Who amongst us make dua for their parents? Look at the prophets of Allah Azza wa Jal. The first Rasul, the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, is the first messenger to the people of earth. قَالَ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِيَ مُؤْمِنًا وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَلَا تَزِدِ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا تَبَارًا. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive the believing women and the believing person who enters my house. Forgive the believing men and the believing women. I will not increase the unjust people except in destruction. The Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, Rabbi ufirli wali walidayya walil mu'minina yawma yaqumul hisab. Oh Allah, forgive me, forgive my parents and the believing people, Muslims on the day of judgment. These prophets, they used to make dua for their parents. Where am I, alhamdulillah, where are you with regards to dua for your parents? Ikhwanifillah, the righteous Muslims were amazed when it came to the issue of their parents. The generation that came after the Sahaba is called the Tabi'in. One of the greats of the Tabi'in, Muhammad ibn Sirin, whenever he used to be next to his mother, he would keep so quiet and his voice would go so low that the people would think he's sick, he's not well. Another one, Ibn Awd al-Muzani. One day his mother calls him, Ya Ibn Awd, yes, mother. He replied in a voice higher than the voice of his mother, فَأَعْتَقَ رَقَبَتَيْنِ. And he freed two slaves as a result. He saw he made a mistake. You are one of the scholars, if you look at the six books of hadith, the great six books of hadith, Imam Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawud, Al-Nasa'i, Tirmidhi, and Ibn Majah. These are the six sunans, the six books of hadith. This scholar, Muhammad ibn Bashar al-Abdi, Buddha, his son of Buddha, all these six books are narrated as hadiths. He's a rawi or narrator that appears in all the six books. Imam Dahabi rahimahullah says, the scholars of his time, they used to seek out the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They go to different cities. They go to Rayn, they go to Marw, they go to Qahira, Dimash, Halab. They go to many cities to seek hadith of the Prophet alayhi salam, because the Sahaba died in different areas and they left their knowledge in different areas. So the scholars used to travel. Except this man, Lam Yarhal, Birra al-Ummi. He did not seek or travel to seek the hadith because he was good to his mother. His mother, he says, Rahmanullah, says, أردت الخروج لطلب العلم. I wanted to go seek the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فمنعتني أمي. And my mother said no. فأعطعتها. And I obeyed her. فبورك لي فيه. And Allah blessed me that I became the former scholar of Basra. Alhamdulillah, consider the majority age here is maybe 25, 30. Imagine this man is in his 40s. He wants to go travel. He says, Mom, I want to go travel to Makkah and Medina to seek knowledge. Mom says no. And he sits and he remains in the city. And Allah gave him barakah in that. Ya Allah, Alhamdulillah, Talq al-Habib, Rahimahullah. This man, he used to kiss his mother's forehead. And he will not walk on this first floor when the mother is on the ground floor. Ijlal and biha, because of the respect he had for her. You have another one, Ali ibn Hussein ibn Ali ibn Talib, the great grandson of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This man, the people used to say, we see you the best person with regards to your mother, but we never see you eating with your mom. Why don't you eat with your mom? He says, wallahi fear, if a plate of food is kept on the table like a biryani or something, فَتَسْبِقُ يَدِي. My hand reaches out to something that my mother was eyeing. She was eyeing that piece of chicken or that piece of meat or that thing. My hand reaches out and grabs that piece of meat. فَأَقُونُ عَقَقْتُوَا بِذَالِ. I become disrespectful because of that. One of the sheikhs in Medina, he told us the following story. He says, in the city of Abha, there was a lady with cancer, stage 4. The last, one of the last, if the last stage of cancer. Yani she can't be helped, she's going to die. So the brother says, that he says that this is the greatest blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted me. Huh? Why? He says, I have been washing my mother with my own hands. The sheikh says, this is not correct, this is wrong. You should not touch the awra, she's not your wife. But it has happened, it has happened. The brother says, one day I was sitting in the sitting room with my brothers. Then my mother, she lifted her head up and down. And I understood that she wanted to relieve herself. She wanted to defecate to urinate. فَقُلْتُ لِلْإِخْوَانِ الْعَشَاء عَشَاء. I said to the brothers, supper time, supper time. فَفَهِمُوا مُرَادِي. They understood what I wanted. And they left the gathering. So they left. I closed the door. I let mom relieve herself. Once she relieved herself, I washed my mother. I dressed her. I perfumed her. And I kissed her on the forehead. فَقُلْتُ لَهَا. I said to her, يَا أُمَّا. Oh, my mother, give me permission. Grant me permission, I go drop the brothers, 20 minutes I'll be back. Says the mother, أسأل الله أيرضعك في الدنيا والآخرة. Oh my son, ask Allah Azza wa Jal to be pleased with you in this world and in the hereafter. So the brother said, I left the house. 10-15 minutes passes, I've been called on the phone. ارجع إلى البيت فإن الوالدة تعبانة. Come back to the house, mom is very unwell. So I rush back to the house, I find mom unwell. She's unconscious, she's fainted. We call the ambulance, I lift her to the ambulance. As we're going to the hospital, she breathes her last. and she dies. And the last part of one thing that I had from my mom was, may Allah be pleased with you in this dunya and the hereafter. A few years back, in Saudi Arabia, alhamdulillah, two brothers came before a judge. And the judge started crying when he heard this. Any case usually that goes before a judge is usually, between brothers, usually inheritance, something business, land, dunya things. But why did the judge start crying? These two brothers, alhamdulillah, were living in different cities. The younger brother had a bigger family, he was richer, he had more servants, he had more access to healthcare facilities. So he says, he goes to the other city and goes to his brother, older brother, and says, my dear brother, give me my mother, it is my chance now, it's my time to take care of her. The older brother says, are you crazy? Do I give you my gate to Jannah? I had to do my gate to Jannah. Are you no one? And they have conflict amongst themselves, it reaches the judge. The judge starts crying, and he does not know how to rule. So he says, call the mother. The mother is brought to Barifullah in court. She's been carried. She's been carried. The judge asks, oh, ya Umar, who do you choose from your two sons? Do you choose this one or do you choose this one? He says, oh, judge, hada aini wa hada aini. This is my right eye and this is my left eye. How can you tell me to choose between my eyes? So the judge starts crying. After weighing all the things, he says, I rule that this mother should be taken care of by the younger son. He is more capable, there is more access to health facilities, he has a bigger family, he has more servants. Her maslaha is more with the younger one, not the older one. Then in Qur'anullah, the judge says, I've never had a man crying like that in my life. The older brother started crying profusely and saying, oh judge, between me and you is Allah in the day of judgment. How dare you forbid me or prevent me from being taken care of my mother? And a final example, alhamdulillah, just also in Saudi Arabia, one of the sheikhs, whenever he was his brothers and the brothers want to give him some form of iman or remembrance to make him cry, they tell him, remember, what is the last thing you did with your father? And he starts crying. This brother, before he became a sheikh, alhamdulillah, he made a big mistake. He used to go home, he takes the car of his dad and he goes, makes his rounds. Why did the father caught him? No, you're not taking my car on today. I'm not taking your car. This ugly car. Take the car. And he throws the keys to the father. And he leaves. 20 minutes, 30 minutes have passed. Come back to the house. Your father is no more. And the memory that he has with his father, alhamdulillah, is him throwing keys to his father's face. He cannot take it back. He wishes he could take back that one single instance of his life when he disrespected and was disrespectful to his father. Alhamdulillah, treat every moment that we have in this life with our parents as our last moment. In the last 2 years from 2020, 2021, 2022, how many of us have buried people's parents? Go to Langata, go to Kareko. How many parents have been buried in the last 2 years? You might still have your parent. That is the gate of Jannah that is open for you. It has been closed for someone else. The Prophet ﷺ says, رِضَ رَبْ فِي رِضَ الْوَالِدِ وَغَضَبَ رَبْ فِي غَضَبَ الْوَالِدِ. Says the pleasure of Allah is the pleasure of the parent. And the anger of Allah is the anger of the parent. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والمواعظ والذكر الحكيم أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم وهو البر الكريم. أخواني كم فرصة زرعوا سبيس بس كم فرصة ولا إله إلا الله تعظيما لشأنه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله داع إلى رضوانه وعلى آله وأصحابه وإخوانه أما بعد أيها الأحبة know all Muslims that regardless of what we do we can never repay back our parents what they have done for us. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says in authentic hadith لا يجزي ولد والده إلا أن يجده مملوكا فيشتريه فيعتقه. That a pastor will never be completely paid their parent except if they find their parent as a slave and they purchase that parent and they free them for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. In a different hadith, Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, one day he sees a man from Yemen performing tawaf and carrying his mother on his back. And this man, he says lines of poetry. He says, إِنِّي لَهَا بَعِيرُهَا الْمُذَلَّلُ إِنْ أُذِرَتْ رِكَابُهَا لَمُدْعَى. He says that I am like a camel, I'm carrying her. Then he looks at Umar, he says to him, Ya Ibn Umar, أَتُرَانِ جَزَيْتُهَا. Do you see her? I've been good to my mother, I've paid her for what she has done. قَالَ وَاللَّهِ لَا بِزَفْرَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. Not even the first construction, the first contraction she had when she's given back to you, you have not paid it back. يَخَانِ فِي اللَّهِ. We cannot pay back our parents, but we can do some things for them. Some of us have been our parents who are non-Muslims. They're not Muslims. Look at the great example of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Ya abati, la ta'budi shaytan. Do not worship shaytan, oh my father. He tries calling him to Islam, Ibrahim alayhi salam. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he's narrated most of the hadith of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One day he calls his mother, who is a polytheist in Islam, oh mom, become a Muslim. The mother insults Islam and insults the Prophet alayhi salatu wa salam. He starts crying, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. And he goes to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, Ya Rasulullah, إني دعوت أمي اليوم فأصبحت فيك ما أكره. Oh Prophet, I called my mother to Islam today and she mentioned bad things about you. أدعو الله أن يهدي أبو هريرة. Oh Prophet, ask Allah to guide the mother of Abu Huraira. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he raises up his blessed hands and he says, اللهم اهدي أم أبو هريرة. Oh Allah, guide the mother of Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira is his mother عنه. I left the gathering. I was so happy, I was crying with tears of happiness. I reached the door of my house. Then I take her to her mom, says, stop there, whatever, stay in your place. And she pours water on herself, and she puts on a hijab, and she comes around and says, Ya Abu Huraira, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. I bear witness that there's no deity worthy of worship except Allah, and Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Abu Huraira goes back to the Prophet والسلام, to give him this glad tidings, and the Prophet والسلام, makes for him more dua. This is a son who took action to save the parent from the hellfire, who took action to bring them to Jannah. So the first thing, you call them to Islam. The second thing, make dua for your parents. The Prophet والسلام, says, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانُ قَضَى عَنْهُ عَمَلُ إِلَّا بِإِحْدَى الثَّلَاثِ قَالَ الْوَلَدُ صَالِحٌ يَدْعُ لَهُ. He says, when a person dies, all the deeds end. Except three things. He mentions shams, sadaqatun jariya, ilmun yintafa'u bih, and the third thing he mentions is waladun salih yad'u lah. The young or the child who makes dua for the parent. Make istighfar, oh Allah, forgive mom, oh Allah, forgive my father. That should be the message for this khutbah. We always make dua for our parents. Go back home and kiss the forehead of your mother. Go home, or right now call your mom, we've not called them for a few days. A few days ago, subhanAllah, in Masjid Salam in Salt City, there's a lady, she was brought to janazah. 4 days, alhamdulillah, she was dead in the house, and she has children. 4 good days, no one knew about her, she was dead in the house, 4 days, and she has children. What else should I do to answer to Allah Azza wa Jal? The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says that a man enters Jannah, and he rises up in Jannah. He's overtaking people in Jannah. He says, this is strange, why am I overtaking all these people that I thought they were even much better than me? Prophet ﷺ says that Rasul will be told, Bi istighfari waladika laka ba'dak. Because your child was making istighfar for you. Your parents, barakallah, they died not to finish the month of Ramadan. Prophet ﷺ was asked by a lady, my dad, mom died, she has Ramadan, do I pay for Ramadan? Qala, sumi anha. Perform the siyam for her. Died, hajj. Perform the hajj for her. And the best thing, barakallah, as mentioned the hadith and conclude this, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام says, أَبَرُّ الْبِرِّ أَيَسْلَ رَجْمُ مُتَّابِهِ. The most best thing that you can do for your parents, when you allow their dad, is being good to the people. They used to find happiness with them. Your dad used to go to coffee houses or meet some of his friends. Once he's died, don't let that relation end. Be good to those people that your father or your mother was finding happiness with. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك اللهم على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك على كل شيء قدير. إنما بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. ورضى اللهم الخلفاء أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وأنصار صحابتي ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم صل ونصر الدين واخذل من خذل عبادك الموحدين اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين